Yeah, I don't know. Did I save? I keep forgetting if I, like, saved or if I'm just, like... Yeah, that was a save, yeah. Okay. Are we here? Bastila.
Revan, I knew you'd come for me.
I'll never give up on you, Bastila. I know you can still be saved.
You're wasting your time. I've seen the Jedi for what they are. Weak and afraid. The Sith are the true masters of the Force. You've forgotten that lesson, Revan. Now you must pay the price. Here on the Starforge, the power of the dark side is at its strongest. This time, you will not defeat me.
Well, I've literally just defeated, like, 50 or 60 Dark Jedi, so... Oh, it's one-on-one, huh? You wanna go one-on-one. Alright, Bastila. I wonder if she's using... Because I did equip... No, she by default uses a double-bladed lightsaber, doesn't she? That was, like, her actual weapon that she starts with. I was gonna say, because I, like, made it so that that's her, like, best weapon. And, I'm like, I wonder if they just gave her a double-bladed because of that, but... Because of, based on what she was actually carrying. Anyways, whatever. We may as well, you know, go all out, I guess. So we want to use some hyper battle stimulants. Hyper adrenal strength. We got 22 of them. Here we go. We're fully decked out. Force Whirlwind didn't do anything. Oh man, Bastila. This is not looking good for you.
I see now why Malak followed you. Even though you're only a shell of your former self, you're still a formidable opponent. I can't even imagine the power you must have wielded when you were the Dark Lord. You were a fool to give it all up and follow the light side.
I'm as strong in the light as I ever was following the dark side.
The dark side has made me stronger than I ever was before. I have a greater command of the Force than all but the most powerful Jedi masters. As Malak teaches me the greatest secrets of the Sith, I will unlock more of my potential. Eventually, there'll be no limit to what I can accomplish with the Force.
God, I hate this choppiness so much. I feel like it's ruining a lot of these videos. It's like, I can just imagine people, like, watch this and they're like... Ugh. So infuriating. It's like... frustratingly slow to, like, sit through. But I let it play because I want the voice acting to be there, but I can't do anything about it is the thing. It's like, it's just the fucking... it's the disc or the console being just so fucking old at this point that it just doesn't properly function anymore. Which is why I should have played it on PC, but, like, I don't know. It's way too late for that at this stage, so I'm just dealing with it. I feel like I need to reiterate that many times. Malak will never let you become that powerful. He will kill you first.
Have you forgotten the ways of the Sith already, Revan? Eventually, Equally, I will challenge my master. If I am worthy, he will die by my hand, and I...
Well, unless he kills you first, why wouldn't he just kill you first?
Master. Then I will take on my own apprentice, and the cycle will begin again. This is the way of the Sith. It is how we assure our leaders are always the strongest and most worthy.
You kind of just ignored my point, though, is that... Okay, whatever. You're dooming yourself to an endless cycle of death and betrayal.
No, Revan. It is you who are doomed.
You want to go... Oh, God. I kind of hate how it got rid of all of the stuff I fucking did.
Gotta do it all again. Ugh.
One more. There we go. Let's throw a heal out and then just force whirlwind, some power attacks. Force whirlwind. Didn't do anything. Whatever. No. No worries.
You are growing weary. I can sense it. Your strength falters. The light's side is failing you.
While wishful thinking.
Starforge re-energizes me. Soon this will all be over.
Oh, wow. What would happen if I said that? I mean, the way she's been talking, it just seems like she would just kill me. It doesn't seem like a very effective thing to do. Your emotions get the better of you, Bastila. Remember the Jedi code.
You dare spew those Jedi lies in my face? You will die screaming, Revan.
Alright, well. I'm not even gonna bother. Well, actually, some of them stuck. It only takes about two of these before I, Oh.
This is not possible. You have rejected the dark side. You are a weak and pathetic servant of the light. How can you still stand against me? Why can't I defeat you?
Now you see the dark side is not stronger than the light.
Yes, I see you speak the truth. I am no match for you. Please, for the sake of what we once shared, do not make me suffer. End my life quickly. There is no other way.
No, I'm not gonna kill you. There's no need for me to kill you, Bastila.
What other choice do you have? I have fallen to the dark side. I am the apprentice to the Dark Lord himself. You cannot let me live.
Why not? I was redeemed, Bastila. You can be too.
You were a special case. The council had no other choice. They needed you alive so they could discover the location of the Star Forge. It was an act of desperation. It was my responsibility to watch over you, to make sure you did not slip back into your evil ways.
I swear, this is like the worst it's ever been.
Dark side.
Yeah, that's kind of true. You can't protect someone from the dark side. Each individual must choose their own path.
I suppose you're right. But the path I have chosen is that of the dark side. I don't see any way I could atone for what I've done. I deserve to die.
Oh God, persuasion check. I'm bad at persuasion, dude. I don't want to fail and just have it, like, not... Look into your heart, Basil, and you'll find the light.
There's nothing in my heart but the blackness of the dark.
Son of a bitch. I can't persuade people worth shit, man.
I ask you for an honorable death, but you are too weak to even grant me
that. I should have chosen the second option.
This must end with blood.
Help us defeat the Sith, Basil. This will atone for what you have done.
Yes.
Yes.
I could join you in your battle.
Thank God they gave it. Let me do it.
That alone would not make up for all I have done. Yet it would be a step in the right direction. But how would you be able to trust me? How do you know I wouldn't turn on you when you faced Darth Malak? How do you know the dark side wouldn't make me betray you again?
I don't. I trust you enough to leave myself open to your attack, Bastila.
You play a dangerous game. Are you certain you wish to take this risk? I could end your life and gain Malak's favor with a single stroke of my lightsaber.
You won't. You won't. I know you still serve the light side.
You were brave, and some would say foolish.
Yeah, that's true.
But you were also right. The dark side has not wholly consumed me. I cannot raise my blade against you. I should stay here, though. If we face Malak, I am afraid his dark presence will overwhelm me. It would not be wise to expose myself to such temptation.
That may be true. That may be true. You could use your battle meditation to aid the Republic fleet.
Yes, that would be for the best. You don't need me to defeat Malak anyway. Now I understand that a true Jedi is a match for any Sith, even the Dark Lord himself. I will stay here in this chamber and use my battle meditation to aid the Republic fleet. I am their only hope of destroying the Starforge and ending the Sith menace. You must go and face Malak, but you have to hurry. Once I turn the battle in the Republic's favor, we won't have much time to escape the Starforge before it's destroyed. Good luck, and may the Force be with you.
All right. I mean, at least the FMBs often function pretty well. I think the problem is actually the in-game music. I think it's the soundtrack that's kind of been corrupted a little bit. Because it seems to be during, like, the flourishes of the music.
There, a break in the
when it really starts breaking.
Green Squadron, move in.
Green Squadron, moving in.
Although it only does it during dialogue as well, so... I mean, who's to say? Well, let me not speak too soon. This is,
Green Squadron's troops, we've broken their lines. Bastila is no longer using her battle meditation against us. The tide has turned.
I don't even know what battle meditation actually does. Like, they just say this is Bastila's special power, she uses battle meditation. I don't know what the fuck it does, what does it do? It's very powerful.
Capital ships, reinforce their position.
That's how they were able to defeat Revan in the first place.
The Sith fleet is in disarray. Now's our chance. Get back to Starforge with everything we've got.
It's not like they ever let me use it in combat or anything. Ah, Bastila. Can I heal you? No. So are they just gonna be locked back there? I hope they can get out. Good. Alright, so it's just me against Malak. I think...
I will stay here in this chamber. You must go and face Mal.
Uh-huh. Yep.
Good luck.
Same thing that she said before. Yeah, I think I could have... I had the opportunity to actually bring her with me, but I it might have been fine, but I just don't... I don't know if that was a good idea, because I don't know how he... Like, he basically tortured her to turn her over to the dark side, so I don't really want to expose her to him. I feel like that is a bad idea. Even though at the same time, well, there's maybe some closure to be had of her doing that, taking out Malik. Might help her with her issues, but, you know. Maybe just better off leaving that to me, you know. Alright. So, there's some doors. There's a lot of doors. Do any of these doors... This door might be fake. Might be a fake door. Yeah, that door's fake. I think both of these doors seem to lead somewhere, though. So this is the Starforge, huh? There's a lot of, like, vague stuff in here. Like, what the fuck is even the Starforge? I mean, they know it does a whole bunch of things. Apparently they use it to craft ships really quickly, but it also powers the dark side of the Force somehow. It's pretty powerful thing, I guess. Okay, so this door's faked as well. Okay, I wanted to verify, because it kind of looks like there's, on the mini-map, it looks like there's a blue, a blue door there, but that's just, optical illusion, I guess. So we'll go this way. I might have to take on an army all by myself. Let's just hope that's not the case. Just gonna save over our previous save. I would say that might be a little bit unfair, but at the same time, I don't think I would put it past the game to do that. So, what's the point of this? Accessing droid generator. Generator inactive. Okay, well, this might be some sort of trap, huh? Are they gonna generate a bunch of droids? He's gonna turn these on and generate a bunch of droids, and they're gonna... Because they're not on right now. Just kind of, ominous. Seems like it might be an effective plan, you know? Walk me into this room, start generating a bunch of droids. I gotta go around, turn all the terminals off. I don't know what the point of these would be otherwise. I'm checking all these just in case. There's like something in one of them, I don't know. I watched Maleficent last night. You know what? Maleficent's not on fucking Disney Plus. I wanted to watch it, because I kind of want to watch all the, like, Disney stuff that I miss. Like, that's one of the live-action ones that I missed. I've seen, like, Beauty and the Beast, but I wanted to watch, like, Lion King and Mulan. So I tried to find, like, a list of all of them just so I didn't miss any. And that was, like, the... it wasn't the first one on there, but it was, like, the first one I was, like... hadn't seen and was, like, interesting enough that I was like, I'll watch that. So, yeah. It's just, like, a complete reimagining of Sleeping Beauty, which I thought it was just gonna be a, you know, a prelude to set it up, but no, it just redoes the entire story of Sleeping Beauty, but focusing around Maleficent.
I tire of this game, Revan. You have been a thorn in my side from the moment I seized the mantle of Dark Lord from your feeble grasp. You made a mistake coming here, Revan. The Starforge fuels my command of the dark side. You are no match for me here, and this time you will not escape.
It's you who can't escape, Malik. Surrender and the Jedi might show you mercy.
Is that what you call it? You think stripping away your power and your identity was an act of mercy, Revan? I would rather die.
I was saved from the darkness, Malik. You can be too if you wish. I do still kind of feel like that was, you know, a bit of a fucked up thing to do. It's like just completely wipe somebody's brain, turn them into a different person. And even if they are evil, at the same time, I get it. I don't know.
Spoken
I don't know
like
how
a
I feel like that. That's a, that's just
a,
such a weird...
Save your preaching, Revan. I will have none of it. You are an insignificant speck beneath my notice. I have surpassed you in every way and accomplished what you never could. I have unleashed the full potential of this Rakatan factory. You had no idea of the power within this place. Its very walls are alive with dark side energies. And now, my old master, I will let the Star Forge itself destroy you.
You gonna blow it up? Oh. Well, I saw this coming, huh? Yeah, that was a little predictable. Very loud. Alright, forged droids. Fine. I gained some light side points, so that feels good, right? So I'm assuming I'm gonna have to go around and try to... I assume this is just gonna... Yeah. Oh, that'd be useful. I can do that. Droid's not responding properly. Well, this would probably be better than... Let's just go ahead and do that. Oh, I don't have enough. Disable. Yep. All right. E. Oh, I don't have nearly enough spikes for this. What am I gonna do? What's a man to do if you don't have enough spikes? I get spikes from this? Got a spike. Alright, well, whatever. I guess I'll destroy these. Don't really know what else to do. I assume it's just gonna recharge them. Like, keep making them, right? Maybe I can destroy some of these? Yeah, see, there's another type F here. Oh. Not super sure what to do here. There's a computer spike. So I've got 9, so I can disable this one. Yep. So this was terminal type C. So I can probably kill droid type C here. And it won't respawn. Should probably get rid of all the ones that aren't gonna respawn. So, I've dealt with this one off. Yeah, okay, D's off. So, let's go ahead and kill D. Okay. Okay, E should already be off as well, so let's get rid of E. I think anything after D should already be disabled. Okay, we've got B, F should be disabled, probably. What's this one behind me? Why is the... Okay, E's... Never mind. E is not disabled. So... We got B, A, and E. Still online. Oh, I don't have enough. Oh boy, okay. We just gotta go around and collect as many spikes as we can. This is just how this is gonna go, I guess. Kinda silly. Okay, there's a spike over there. Is that one not disabled? It should be. Type F? Oh, it's probably because I destroyed type F. Okay. So we still got three left. Oh, man. Alright. This just kind of feels like a little bit of a waste of time here more than anything. So, terminal type E. Still don't have enough. Alright, where's E? It's gonna be a real slow process. Unfortunately, or I should say fortunately, I guess, they don't have nearly enough firepower. I think that it was a big benefit for me to, you know, make my character in such a way that I can equip heavy armor, like the best armor in the game, so that, you know, nothing can really do as much damage as they probably want it to. Like, this would be... I'd imagine, like, depending on my character setup, right? Like, I could have a really... Like, a character that just doesn't use armor whatsoever. I've built my character in such a way that they... you know, maybe I built, like, a stealth character. And so they put something like this up against me. I wouldn't stand a fucking chance. And it would be pretty unfair, honestly. To be like, oh, you can set your character up in any way you want, but you'll really get screwed at the end. Alright, so there's only two left. Alright, get out of my way. We'll focus on B here. I don't think it's unnecessary. You know what I mean, though? Kind of a fucked up thing to do in an RPG. I've had it happen before, though. I have had it happen where I've set up my character and it's just like... They just put you in some situation where you're just not equipped to deal with it. In an effort to, you know, up the stakes. But, you know, we're kind of in the reverse of that where... It's a little too easy for us, given the situation. But yeah, Maleficent. It was okay, it was alright. It is really dumb that it's not on Disney Plus, though. They have the second movie, but they don't have the original. It's like, what the fuck is that about? Disney? Like, that's pretty dumb. So I had to, like, rent it from, like, Amazon Prime or something and watch it. I don't know, it was cute. Cute movie, I guess. Yeah. That's about all I have to say about it. What else did I watch? I watched, oh man, there was another movie I watched this weekend. Oh, Star Trek Beyond. I watched Star Trek Beyond finally, because... I hadn't watched it. I watched Star Trek 2009, like, the year it came out. Me and my friend went and saw it in theaters because we were, like, huge Star Trek nerds. And honestly, I really liked Star Trek 2009 when it came out. I think I may have watched it one or two times since. I still think it's, like, for what it is, like, still pretty cool movie. I honestly liked it a lot. But I know a lot of people don't. All those Star Trek purists out there, because it doesn't really feel like it really, like, tries to be super, you know, stick close to the heart of what Star Trek was as a show. Instead, it just tries to kind of be an action movie, but also have these... It tries to just put these characters in, like, a cool, like, modern action situation, you know? Kind of, like, revamp the idea of it. Which, I mean, I think it's fine for, like, what it is, you know? That's what it's trying to do, and that's what it does, so... Like, I honestly thought it was pretty cool. And some of the action scenes, I think, are pretty cool, especially given, like... what the budget of the original Star Trek shows were. You know, it's like to see the like ship is like tilting and they start running on the walls and shit, and it's like, you know, you can really be, it's like you really feel like they're in a big ship in space, and there's issues of grav. I guess it doesn't really make scientific sense, but whatever. I don't know, there's something cool about that. Yeah, I didn't like In the Darkness that much, you know, and that's kind of why I think I didn't watch Star Trek Beyond. I was like, In the Darkness kind of sucked. So, like, do I really need to watch Star Trek Beyond? And so it took me forever, like, I only just watched it. And the only other one was, why is it doing this? Stop. Fuck. Started slowing down for no reason. Okay. I should have enough spikes to finish this off now. But Star Trek Beyond was pretty cool. It was definitely better than Into Darkness, so... I had a good time with it. It's still... You know, if you really think about it... If you think about it too hard, like... It's... It doesn't really make much sense. I mean, they've got... Basically, the plot is there's this captain and his ship crashes on some other planet, and then he, like, tries to call Starfleet, but they don't, respond. He turns out they went through, like, a wormhole or something in, like, an offhand comment that was, like, the explanation for how they ended up there, and they were, like, so far away that they couldn't contact the Federation. Stop. But, like, for some reason, there were some things that I didn't, like, understand. I'm like, why is he... I think I just saved and, like, did I? Yeah, I just saved, but I want to save again. Like, for some reason, he, like, turns into an alien, and then he's got a bunch of alien... He's got, like, an alien army, which I'm like, is that supposed to be his crew? It doesn't really explain why they turn into aliens for some reason. It's just for plot convenience at the end when they reveal... You know, the big twist is that the aliens were actually this crew the whole time, but it's like, but why would they look like aliens then? It doesn't really explain it at all. Like, okay, all right. Yeah, the aliens' plan didn't really make much sense, because the aliens' plan was, like, to get this... get this thing that creates this gas that, like... destroys the molecules of living beings, and then he goes to this, like, research, this, like, weird glass planet. It's not really a planet, it's like a fake planet that people live in, and he's gonna unleash it on this planet for some reason and kill everyone. For some reason, that was his plan. And he got this whole alien army on his side.
I was certain the defenses of the Starforge would destroy you. But I see there is more of your own self in you than I expected. You are stronger than I thought. Stronger than you ever were during your reign as the Dark Lord. I did not think that was possible.
The light side is stronger than you know, Malik.
I am tempted to try and capture you alive, Revan. Then I could break your will and bind you to me as my apprentice, as I did Bastila.
But Malik, that's
you
what the Jedi did.
You'll be a greater asset to me than even Bastila and her battle meditation, if I could control you. But is it worth the risk? Perhaps you are too powerful to be my apprentice. I betrayed you when I realized my own strength was greater than yours. In time, you might try to do the same to me.
Yeah, that's just, you know. That's how the dark side goes. Everybody's just trying to one-up each other all the time. This is your last chance, Malik. Surrender.
No, Revan. This time our confrontation can only end in death. Yours or mine. Once again,
kinda
we
figured.
Shall face each other in single combat, and the victor will decide the fate of the galaxy.
All right, Malik. I guess we'll do this. May as well keep boosting myself. I don't think... Like, if Bastila was any indication, then this is not going to be too difficult, probably. Oh, nope, he's strong. He's actually pretty strong. It would be nice to have force suppression. Wow. Okay. This reminds me of that fucking... Oh, God, I'm gonna lose. Cancel. I need, to use a life support pack and, a bunch of advanced med kits. Please hurry. Okay. Didn't get it out in time. Oh boy, alright. He is actually stronger than I thought he was gonna be. Alright. This is the first time it's been like a one-on-one battle and somebody has actually been extremely powerful. Even with all the stimulants that I used. That's wild. So I'm gonna have to use the stimulants, it looks like. But yeah, otherwise it was a fun little thing for what it was. I don't know. I get why people don't like him. You know, they don't really feel very Star Trek-y, but it's fine. It's like its own little thing that they're doing, so I don't mind it. Plus, it seems like it's over now. They haven't made a new one since. Well, actually, let me think about it. 2009 to 2016. That's 7 years. And it's been 5 years. No, they probably would have made another one by now. But I know the actor that played, Chekhov, had a tragic accident, passed away. So maybe that's part of the reason they don't want to, like, do it again, bring him back. A lot of the actors are doing other stuff as well. Chris Pine, I think, has moved on to other shit, and
well done, Revan.
The guy that did Dr. McCoy.
I am tempted to
doing other stuff.
Perhaps
I don't know. They're all big TV actors, except Chris Pine is kind of still a movie star. But like Dr. McCoy, I forget what the guy's name is. But he's in The Boys. He's the you know. He's the guy
no
in The Boys.
Revan. Once again.
Zachary Quinto. I remember the first time I saw Zachary Quinto was from Heroes. He was the villain in Heroes. I think it's just better if I just use the hyper stuff. I do kind of wish that I'm going to use a life support pack. I think the life support pack will keep me alive or something. Hurry up. It takes so long. Alright. Let's do two. Power attack. Plan for another. Power attack. Do it. Great. Good job. What the fuck? Really? What the hell was that?
You continue to amaze me, Revan. If only you had been the one to uncover the true power of the Starforge, you might have become truly invincible. But you were a fool. All you saw was an enormous factory. All you ever imagined was an infinite fleet rolling forth to crush the Republic. You are blind, Revan. Blind and stupid.
There's some point to this.
The Starforge is more than just a space station. In some ways, it is like a living creature. It hungers, and it can feed on the dark side that is within all of us.
Okay.
Look around you, Revan. See the bodies? You should recognize them from the Academy. These are Jedi who fell when I attacked Dantooine. For all intents and purposes, dead. Except for one difference. I have not let them become one with the Force. Instead, I have brought them here. The Starforge corrupts what remains of their power and transfers the dark taint to me.
Ah.
You cannot beat me, Revan. Not here on the Starforge. Not when I can draw upon the power of all these Jedi. And once you are beaten, I will do the same to you. You will be trapped in a terrible existence between life and death. Your power feeding me as I conquer the galaxy.
Okay. What if I just do something about him? Okay. I don't really... This is kind of fucked up, isn't it? Let's use a life support pack and then try to build ourselves up again. Because it just kind of removes all our shit. Probably gonna need another life support pack. Continue. And then we'll try to do that. And we'll hopefully knock him out. Hurry. Might need a third. Whoa. Let's get another one in. There you go. Okay, he's running. Kind of annoying. Is it just, this is just what it's gonna be? It's gonna take forever. Oh god, this is gonna take forever, okay. Alright. That's what we're doing. Come on, go for it. Missed. Not good. There it goes again. There's quite a lot of these guys. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more. Is there some thing I can do? The only thing that would worry me is if these guys come back. So that guy's been used up. How many of these do I have left? I have a few. I wonder if I can, like, Maybe if I throw some grenades out here instead. It'd be fun. That didn't really work. Whatever. Oh god. Oh god, use them faster, please. The issue here is that I think I've run out of, Alright. Yeah, okay. It's because my things have worn off. So let's just spam these and survive, and hopefully if we get the next attack off, we should be okay. Is he? Okay, great. Wonderful. There we go. Now he's gonna do that, which is a good opportunity for me to recharge all of this. Come on. There you go. Alright. Three more after this. We were running low on life support packs. So we need to get out there. Please go. Come on. How are we missing? God damn it. Am I out? No. Okay, I have 8 left. Why did I miss all of those attacks? Oh, did he cancel them out somehow? No, okay. I need them to be these, so. There he goes. And three more. I mean, is there any way I can just, like, release them or something instead? I didn't really try to do that. I mean, I tried with the first guy, but he was already used up, so I don't know if that would have made a difference, you know? Let's give it a go. Yep. Only by using the power of the Force. Force power did not affect the machine that binds him, okay. Alright, well, I don't really know what I could do there then. Maybe some specific power I need, but I don't know what it is. I got Force Aura. That's not gonna do anything. Alright, well, whatever. Let's get after it. Come on. Ugh. This is rough. Just one more hit. Go. I don't know what I lost. I think it's this shield. Okay, so the next one would be the battle stimulant, whichever, if I go back down to 3, it's the battle stimulant that I've lost. Let's go. Oops. Okay, I'm down to 2. Alright, I've lost the battle stimulant. And hyperadrenal strength. Okay. I just lost something else as well. I'm losing everything. Why am I losing everything? Is it glitched? Is it glitched? Alright, let's just use it all again, I guess. I literally just use strength, so I'll use stamina and run another battle simulant, I guess. I don't really understand why I've lost all of my... Come on. Alright, there's something missing, I don't know what it is. So... Let me get back to using a life support pack and then just try to take him out. Because he is out of Jedi abilities, or Jedi to use. And I am out of life support packs. Come on. I don't know what's gone, and it's bothering me. Like, what the fuck did I lose? I think I've lost strength, stamina. I have to have lost... Like, do I have shield? I don't know, man. I don't think I have shields. Come on. Master. Alright. I'm about to die, because I can't tell what I've lost here. Come on. Med packs, faster. Med packs. Faster med packs. Faster. Alright. Where's he going? Can I save? What if I save here? Okay, I can just save there. Oh god. I hope that doesn't break it or anything. Oh, there was another guy here? I didn't even see him. Shit. Well, now that I'm all confused with what I have equipped and what I don't. Let's just hope that things just kind of go well, you know? Stop. Desperately need to just stay alive here for now, but the thing is, without the life support packs, it's gonna be a little bit difficult to stay alive. Very close. No, fuck you. Certainly isn't helping that we've lost everything again. All of our stimulants. Okay, last and kind of unnecessary, but... Shit. Oh, fuck you! Hit! Hit the bastard. That's all you need to do. There you go.
Impossible. I cannot be beaten. I am the Dark Lord of the Sith.
This is the way of the dark side, Malak. All things end in death.
Still spouting the wisdom of the Jedi, I see. Maybe there is more truth in their code than I ever believed. I cannot help but wonder, Revan, what would have happened had our positions been reversed? What if fate had decreed I would be captured by the Jedi? Could I return to the light as you did? If you had not led me down the dark path in the first place, what destiny would I have found?
I am sorry I started you on this path, but you chose to continue down it.
I suppose you speak the truth. I alone must accept responsibility for my fate. I wanted to be master of the Sith and ruler of the galaxy. But that destiny was not mine, Revan. It might have been yours, perhaps, but never mine. And in the end, as the darkness takes me, I am nothing.
Well, all right then.
There you are. What happened?
Darth Malak is dead. It's over, finally.
That's wonderful news. There's no time to celebrate just yet. I was able to use my battle meditation to allow the Republic to break through the Sith fleet. The capital ships are in bombardment range.
And that means we all have to get out of here right now before this entire complex comes down around our ears. Everyone else is already on the ship. Let's move.
Let's go. Did I put Bastila in the Dark Jedi robes, or did... Because I know I had Dark Jedi robes. It's very possible. I think I might have, actually. I don't even know. I don't remember. I definitely didn't give her a red lightsaber, so... I could see them just kind of doing that.
Admiral Dodonna, we've hit their main orbital stabilizers.
Everyone pull back. I don't want to lose any ships when that space station goes down.
We did it, Vandar. The Sith are routed, and the Starforge destroyed.
But at what cost, Admiral? Where is the Ebon Hawk and her crew?
Yeah, where are we?
Thank you.
Oh, we made it. Yay.
You made it.
We couldn't let you start the victory party without us, Admiral.
Just barely.
I'm sending an honor guard to escort you in. You'll be getting a hero's welcome when we all get home.
Yay. We did it. Oh, we all just... We landed on the Uncharted Starforge subsystem, whatever thing.
Starforge and broken the spirit of the Sith. For this, I am proud to present you each with the Cross of Glory. The highest honor of the Republic. From Coruscant to the farthest reaches of the Outer Rims, you will be known as the Saviors of the Republic.
Sick.
On behalf of the Jedi Council, defenders of the galaxy, and sworn protectors of the Republic, I too would like to honor you for your actions. We Jedi now have another tale to weave even to the grand history. Wherever you go, you will be recognized as the saviors of the galaxy, the heroes of our age. But you must remain ever vigilant, for one day you may be called upon yet again to defend the glory of the Republic against the tyranny of the dark side.
Wow. That cutscene was so fucking broken. Oh my god. How nice. We did it. We're the heroes. I'm so sorry that this game ran like shit. Next time at the first sign of some issue like that. Oh, it's playing the... Oh no, I'm gonna get claimed for the Star Wars theme. Next time that happens, I will be sure to pick a different version of the game. Because it really did, I think, ruin a lot of these. But, you know, we finally made it. This game did feel like it was kind of just... It was dragging out a little bit, but I think it's mostly because... that sounds like a very negative thing to say at the end of it. But let me just... Yeah, I think it's mostly because the episodes, like, we managed to finish Grandia in under, or I managed to finish Grandia in under 60 episodes, I think in under 50. I think we ended in the 40s, late 40s, right? So, yeah, but this game just kept going on for a little bit, even though it seemed like we're at the end. But these episodes were distinctly shorter. A whole, like, 40 minutes shorter than those episodes, so... it makes sense that that would happen. But yeah, I think we're ending somewhere in the 60s. And, it took quite a while. It was, you know, I don't want to say it was a struggle to kind of finally, like, finish this game off. I kept coming back to it, and I would record, like, an hour or so, and I was like... Oh, I just want to... Oh, man, I'm ready to pack it in here, come back to this another day. You know, so these last few hours have taken me quite a while to actually just, you know, go ahead and finish off the series, but, you know... We did it. I did it. The only thing I'm worried about is, like, if I do play Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2... If there is a way to transfer save data over, then I might be a little bit screwed. I might be a little bit locked into the Xbox version, but there might be a way to I'm sure there's a way, somebody's created like a save file generator for PC to like generate some sort of transfer character, and I might be able to just, you know, build what I have here and transfer it over to PC if that is something I want to do. I don't really plan on playing it anytime soon, We might. I mean, it just depends. Luck of the draw is kind of how I go about doing these things. But yeah, what did I think of the game? Well, it's a little wonky, and I don't just mean by, I don't know. I think a lot of the wonkiness did kind of just come from the, you know, the game kind of chugging behind, you know. I'm putting out actions, and they don't really happen right away. But I don't know. During some of the fights, it did feel like I would try to put something in, and then it wouldn't, like, go off in time. You know, there's, like, a delay between me putting the action in and it actually happening. So, you know, I'd get to low health and not really have any time to actually save myself. You know, I would have to kind of preempt it before I got low enough to take one hit and die. I liked it for the most part. I think the dialogues, the persuasion stuff was a little bit basic. It's either, you know, there's not, like, different, you know, because I'm thinking of, like, Fallout, where it's, like, depending on what skills and attributes you have, like, you get different persuasion options. Like, say I'm an expert, you know, in computers, maybe I'd get an option for, you know, expressing my knowledge of computers in a dialogue and maybe unlocking some things. So it's very basic in terms of, you know, the actual dialogue system. It's just a success or a failure, and it's purely dependent on charisma and persuasion, which I regret not focusing more points in, you know, especially in an RPG like this. It's kind of the best thing you can do, because it's what gives you the most... It often gives you the easiest path, but it often gives you the most interesting options as well. Like, it allows a lot of the more interesting things to happen. Like, you can persuade people into doing interesting stuff and changing the story in quite a large way. the way this game works, I don't know if, like, the dark side path would actually be that different. I think the dark side path, it would probably be... you know, your crew's kind of going along with you, but you're still doing the same thing. You end up in the Starforge, and maybe you just, in that final moment, you just take over and become the Dark Lord of the Sith instead. But then I don't know how that would transfer over to Knights of the Old Republic 2, honestly, you know. That's another thing to think about. But yeah, this is a BioWare game. They made Mass Effect, so... I do kind of anticipate that Knights of the Old Republic 2, that's the one that kind of makes it on the best of lists, usually, is like, best games of all time. Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, it's the one that's a little bit more highly lauded, so that might have a more intricate system. But, you know, generally I liked it. It was very, very playable. You know, there were no points in which I felt like I was really struggling against the systems or the way the game, you know, was set up. It was just, you know, the way it was running. Oh, that's just it. It just ends. No extra anything. What else is there to say about it? I mean, yeah, I think it's a cool game for what it is. Very interesting. If it ran a lot better, I think I would have thought it was pretty great, honestly. But, you know, it's not really the game's fault, I guess. But, yeah, I think... Yeah, I mean, we're returning to an RPG where, you know, a Western RPG where the systems are kind of basic, and they've since done more complex systems, especially with, like, Mass Effect. And the way that game works is it's, like, very dependent on the choices you make. Is, like, you make a choice, and then it changes a lot of things moving forward, and then you're changing the entirety of how the second game works and how the third game works, and it's like this whole intricate system, which is really cool. And I think the inner workings of that come from this, the sort of skeleton idea come from this. So I am really excited to see how they improved things in the second game. Maybe we can play Mass Effect on the channel, but, you know, I don't know, because I've already played the first Mass Effect. I really liked the characters. I thought the storyline was really cool, really fun. Yeah, it was a good time. Great game. Liked it a lot. I guess I'll just end it here. And I hope to see you guys on whatever else, whatever the next thing is. Who knows? All right, well, goodbye.